This video could save your life. Bushfires love hot, dry, windy days. The hotter and windier it is, the easier it is for a bushfire to get out of control. Fire danger ratings are used on days where there's a greater risk of fires and when you need to take action. When there's no rating, that doesn't mean a fire won't start. But if one does, it's unlikely to spread in a fast or threatening way. It is the perfect time to learn what you need to do to reduce your bushfire risk. When the danger rating is moderate, stay up to date and be alert for fires in your area. Check your bushfire plan and get prepared. If you don't have a plan, make one. When it's high, fires can be dangerous. If a fire starts, your life and property may be at risk. Decide what you will do if a fire starts. An extreme rating means dangerous fire conditions. Put your bushfire plan into action. If you and your property are not prepared to the highest level, leave early. Avoid travel through bushfire risk areas. Catastrophic is as bad as it gets. If a fire starts and takes hold, lives are likely to be lost. Homes are not designed to survive fires in these conditions, and you should leave bushfire risk areas early in the morning or the night before. The single biggest killer in a bushfire is indecision, so always keep an eye on the fire danger ratings and know what you'll do if a fire starts. To check your local fire danger rating, visit emergency.wa.gov.au. Don't have a bushfire plan? Make one today at mybushfireplan.wa.gov.au.